The flood in Kerala was very disastrous and it was very scary. It was a terrible life experience for me. My family had to be shifted to safer place. That day in August 2018, I was on the road in my car. With great difficulty I reached home. The water was rising up. I could see house articles, cows and animals being flown away. People were caught unaware. Everybody climbed on the terrace tops. Look at my own village on the beginning day of the flooding. The whole area was seen like a violent ocean. Tens of thousands of people had to take shelter in relief camps. The initial 2-3 days were very scary. The families who caught in the flood were screaming and begging for life. Floodwaters have submerged thousands of houses, shops, provision stores, groceries, godowns. Everything was drowned in flood. Crops, vegetables and thousands of hectares of cultivation were destroyed. Livestock were smashed away by the heavy flood. All the belongings and household items like kitchen utensils, beds, furniture, chairs, tables, medicines, food materials, everything was lost. The most affected is the poor and the daily wage workers. They have now to rebuild each and everything at home. There were no electricity. Thousands of power connections were disrupted. 450 people died. Many were missing within a fortnight. The flood of this magnitude never happened in 100 years. Almost all the 41 rivers were in spate. Rivers changed course, dams overflowed, and bridges collapsed. Almost all the districts of Kerala were affected. Hundreds of landslides and mudslips occurred in several parts of the state. The water was not only rising up, but it was heavy flow. The great job was done by the fishermen community. They came with their fishing boats, risking their life and rescued the people trapped at various places. One lesson everybody learned from this disaster: the rich and the poor, the Dalits and the high caste, all were in relief camps. All were standing in one queue for food and other supplies. Everybody was under one common shelter for 2 weeks together. The entire people experienced the love of mankind, helping others in whatever fashion they could. In fact, I am thankful to the generous benefactors of CNEWA who supported us to help thousands of people by way of emergency supplies during the flood and otherwise. Of course, we did this through the help of the local church. Dear benefactors, I salute you because you were our good friends at the time of our need, and I look forward to your continuous patronage in God's mission. May He bless you. Thank you.